You are listening to SoFloRadio.com.
Happy Christmas, Jody. So this is Christmas.
Hey everybody, welcome to the Rick Show on the radio, SoFloRadio.com, with my great guests today. Really looking forward to talking to Jared Knowles, AJ Isidore from the WideScreen Film and Music Video Festival. Yes, sir, but let's get in a little holiday spirit. Let's listen to a little bit of John Lennon. We'll come back and we'll talk about the festival, all right? War is over. That was a long war, too. Let's get that one over with. All right. And it is happy Christmas time. We're in the season, and it's nice and warm down here in South Florida, but it'll get cool again. So welcome, everybody. Rick's show on the radio, and I am welcoming Jared Knowles. How you doing?
It's a pleasure to be here.
Good to see you. And AJ, my dear, how are you? We're on the... We got the... cameras up there, so we can wave to your mom if you want to.
Hey, Mom.
Hi, Mom.
Hey,
how's it going?
What's up, guys?
All right, so yes, I've been dying to get you guys on the show here, and this is a good opportunity here for us to talk about your very first film festival, which is, I'm looking around and I'm seeing a lot of buzz about the first annual WideScreen Film and Music Video Festival coming up here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. We're going to have that down at the AMC at...
Aventura.
Yeah.
Yep.
And submissions are already started, right?
Yep. See, we started December 1st, and we're looking pretty solid so far.
Coming in
steadily.
Yeah, I've been following the Facebook things there. It looks like you've already got some international submissions already, right?
Certainly, yeah, from even as far as Malaysia, Italy. We even had, obviously, across the continental U.S. as well. You know, we're doing pretty well.
You must be pretty excited about that,
definitely,
huh?
Definitely France, too, so.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Soon we'll get the extraterrestrials to come out.
Yeah, ET will submit something.
I'm pretty sure they'd be sending it to my friend's Miami Science Fiction Film Festival.
Yeah,
Troy Bernier. He's going to have a science fiction festival where he actually has a category for extraterrestrial submissions.
Oh wow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Speak of the devil.
Yeah. He's pretty on top of things there. All right. So... welcome to the show, you guys, and I want to say that, I've met you guys through the Florida Hampton Table, which is a great networking event and organization that's been around for...
Certainly. Like, yeah, shout out to Rose Warner.
Yeah, hey, Rose, and everybody, and Richard.
Yes, yep. And Richard, definitely. Good people, great people in South Florida.
Yes. We meet once a month over at 84 Diner, and... Really is a great organization for filmmakers and artists to get together and help out the South Florida area. There's a lot of good things that are going on that are new that are promoting South Florida talent here. And your film festival is one of the brightest new stars that are coming up here to support the local filmmaking community. And it's musicians as well, because it's not just like films, it's music videos as well, right?
Film and music, yes. Mm-hmm. It's about having that cross collaboration and creating that real sense of industry here for us. So
Good idea. I really enjoy that cross collaboration thing myself. Being a musician, like I said, I don't know if I ever told you guys, but I've been down here for a while and was a musician. You know, I played professionally in the circuit here for many, many years. Probably been in the same place as George has been, right? Button South.
All the same, but yeah.
Yeah. We're not going to talk about that. But I do have a lot of, musician friend contacts. And when I started working with my friends in the film business, you know, I started making all new friends, but opportunities have come by that I can combine these things together here, at least Rick on Rick's radio show, where I could bring musicians on and filmmakers. And sometimes we all get together and, you know, work on things together, like music videos. And my friend Billy Levesey from the Levesey's, he wrote a song that was on as part of a movie that I did.
Nice.
That's those kind of collaborations, we try to promote those things.
Certainly. Oh, for sure, for sure. And that's what helps like create the strength, and it allows us as an industry to grow, and hopefully South Florida will be on the map just like LA. And so that's what we really want to see, and that's what we're trying to do with this festival, to create more opportunities for that collaboration.
Definitely.
That sounds like a good idea. Do you get on board with that one there? You think that's a... I mean, I know that this is your brainchild, basically, right, Jared?
Certainly.
And tell me, when did you get this idea? Or I'll tell you what. Let's explain a little bit about what the film festival is going to be about. But instead of you doing that, I'm thinking that maybe you have a video here that explains it. So,
oh yes, we do.
If you don't mind, George, would you mind playing a video that for the WideScreen Film and Music Video Festival?
So many creative individuals around town, throughout South Florida, throughout the world. So many creative individuals, so many creative geniuses, but not enough outlets to display this creativity. And the WideScreen Film and Music Video Festival seeks to give filmmakers the opportunity, filmmakers and artists, the opportunity to shine, the opportunity to have their work displayed on the big screen, the way it's meant to be seen, the way they dreamed of it being seen. We seek to make dreams come true. We seek to inspire the creation and distribution of art while ultimately enhancing the creative mind. That, my friends, is our mission statement, and we plan to fulfill that mission. With that said, I'd like to formally introduce myself. My name is Jared Alexander Knowles. I am the president and founder of the WideScreen Film and Music Video Festival, held at AMC 24 Aventura. Our festival commences February 27th, 2015. Our submissions begin December 1st, 2014, and you have until February 8th to get your submissions in. We take a wide range of content, and if you go ahead and check our fan page or our website, you will see the various content that we accept. And we look forward to providing a priceless experience, not just for the filmmakers and the artists, but also for the audience members who will grace us with their presence when our festival commences February 27, 2015, and we run until March 3rd. We have a series of events planned for you that's going to be priceless, and we're going to make history, it's going to be fun, and we're going to have a grand old time. I look forward to seeing you there, and I want to thank you for listening.
All right, and that's the WideScreen Film and Music Video Festival.
Certainly.
Which submissions have opened up on December 1st.
Indeed, indeed.
And we're getting a lot of films. And any idea, can you tell us how many films how many people you've heard from so far?
Oh, yeah, certainly. Well, basically right now, as far as submissions, we're up to about a little over 25. So.
Wow, and it's only been a couple of days.
Yes, certainly.
Mm-hmm. All right, like the early bird is just this the 11th, right?
Right. Yeah, early bird submissions end on January 11th. So I think people are, you know, just racing to get them in before the holidays, and everyone gets caught up. So,
AJ, what's if people want to submit? Or I know we're going to say this a few times throughout the show, but where do they go to get their films?
Widescreenfest.com.
All right, there you go. See, that was a good answer. I thought this was planned in the works for like, you know.
No.
Years and
no.
Oh man, that's
when inspiration hits you, you have to just go with
just
it.
Act
well,
on
that
it.
That's amazing.
You know,
I'm
like
glad.
Just like Steve Jobs said, just act on it, you know. And it's just beautiful because it seems like something that has been in the works because of all of the clout and all the recognition it's getting, but it's just a divine intervention. You know, it's just power, and you know, it's just the momentum that comes when you wholeheartedly pursue your dreams and commit yourself to an ideal. All of a sudden, you know, you inspire a movement, and
it
you
does.
Inspire a generation. You change the world ultimately.
Oh, that's great. It's good to be around people that think that way. It really is. And I appreciate it. We don't really have too many of those local events. Of course, we had the Fort Lauderdale International Film Festival, which just got over. I think that's our oldest, if I can say, you know, at least Broward County's most prestigious film festival so far, you know.
Yes, sir, by far.
Also, I don't know, did you guys know that it was that the Fort Lauderdale International Film Festival is in the Guinness World Records?
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah.
For what?
For being the longest film festival in the world.
I mean, days?
It's like a month and a half.
Oh, wow.
It's even longer than Sundance. Sundance is 2 weeks.
Cons, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's longer. So it's longer.
People want to enjoy the sunshine and the beach, so you got to fit that in.
Yes. Uh-huh. And this is a great time to have a festival, too. And yours is coming up, it'll be in March, right?
February 27th through March 3rd.
Oh, see, that's the most perfect time to be in South Florida, weather-wise, anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
You know, it's really nice and cool. So it's going to be 2 days, right?
No. February 27th through March 3rd. So basically, we're running for a period of 4 or 5 days, basically.
Oh.
Yeah.
Great.
With a pre-party, workshops, and then the
screening days, and then we have the award show.
Wow.
Yeah.
Man, so tell us a little bit about, so you wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning, you call AJ, you say, hey, I'm going to do this film festival. She says, call me later on when I wake up.
No!
and then you guys, you have to think about sponsorships and, you said you have a good connection through AMC and Aventura, which is, you know, for a film festival, that's a great connection right
definitely.
But is there any one person or one event or one thing besides your phone call at 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning to AJ that really got the show going for this film festival?
To be honest with you, I'm a dreamer, I dedicate all my time and energy into my dreams and, my pursuit of what it is that I want to accomplish in life. You know, I don't have a 9-to-5 job and I don't occupy myself doing other things that are not directly related to what I want to accomplish. So for the most part, I mean, not to take credit for myself, but most of it has just been, my efforts and the connections I already have that I applied to this effort, and also God.
That's a great answer. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty inspirational.
I had a great team. I can't forget to thank and acknowledge my team. Once I decided that this is something we're going to do, I committed to it fully. And I contacted AJ and then I put together a nice team. Alexandra Bayo, who is the director of programming, who I brought on board. Karen Slososki, who is one of the marketing coordinators. Mm-hmm. And then we have Dion Say. Not to be confused with Beyonce.
Beyonce. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
She got a pretty cool name, but Beyonce, that's my publicist.
If she marries you.
Yeah.
We could have Beyonce Knowles.
That'd be cool, yeah.
That would be something.
No, but she's my publicist, man. I love her, and she's definitely on top of her game. And basically, she has worked with me before in previous projects, and she's the director of public relations in the festival. So we meet on a weekly basis. We actually have a meeting later on this evening.
Mm-hmm.
And just the team, I give credit to God, the team, AJ, and just the will to never give up.
That's inspirational. If anybody listening out there takes anything out of this whole thing, yes, we got a great film festival, and it's really great that we could do these things, but what Jared said right there is one of the most important things, is that nobody else is going to hand your dreams to you on a platter,
exactly.
Right? Mm-hmm. You gotta dream the dream, and then you have to go and you gotta pursue it. You gotta do it.
Of course.
At all costs.
I know you've heard that before many, many times, but this, here's Jared, he's doing it. So, I mean, how do you do that? Give us a little bit of an idea of what it takes to actually pursue your dream. I mean, what kind of a mindset do you have to have in order to, just bring something like that to fruition?
That's a good question. I love that question. You have to be crazy.
Yeah, all right.
And there's no other way to put it. You have to be crazy. Crazy, not mentally insane, but crazy as in the fact that you're willing to sacrifice it all. Right. Even your own welfare sometimes.
That is a great answer to what you said was a great question. Mm-hmm. It really is, because
sacrifice.
Think about it. I mean, nothing really, anything big or new that happens and then everybody else follows it is started by somebody who's, you know, maybe they're not crazy. Crazy is a metaphor for, you know, somebody who wants to step outside the box.
Right.
You know?
Not normal. You know, you're extraordinary. That's the word.
Extraordinary. Right. Mm-hmm. And unreasonable in your approach to, like, I am going to do this.
Right, you go against the grain, against the status quo, you know, like Steve Jobs said. Steve Jobs is one of my main inspirations, and he was the one that said, you know, the people that think they're crazy enough to change the world are the ones who do.
Right.
So you have to, in order to think outside the box, you have to be abnormal, and there's no other way to put it, and, you know, at the end of the day, you have to be willing to give it all that you've got. All.
Yeah. All. Finance. Alienation from you know, friends, or oh, hey Jared, let's go out and have a fun time tonight. I'm sorry, I can't do that because I have to work on my business plan.
Exactly.
For my, you know, that's the kind of
the
thing
new
you
fun
have. Yeah. Oh, he's no fun, I don't want to hang out with him anymore. But oh, definitely. Now he has a nice film festival, I want to hang out with that.
Exactly. Yeah. So funny that you mentioned that. Yes.
Yeah, oh, well, you have a story about that?
No, it's okay, just yeah, it's just the fact that you know, I mean, everyone wants to be your friend when you're shining, you know.
Yeah, that's true.
But when you're in your, you know, your darkest moments, that's when you realize who your true friends are, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But at the same time, you know, I'm not one to harp on the negativity in life.
No, it's a natural thing. I've noticed that myself.
Yeah.
You know, I started making movies, and ever since I hooked up with George here at the radio show, people want to come on my radio show. It's just a natural thing, you know? There's nothing wrong with that. It's
exactly.
Perfect. It's just a natural way of life, you know?
Right.
But yes.
Had you not been doing this, then perhaps they wouldn't even...
Yeah, they wouldn't be like, oh, hey, Rick, how's it going?
Exactly.
Yeah. That's about it. Mm-hmm. So,
but what you do in life does have a lot to do with your image, how you perceive and how people respond to you. So that's true. Mm-hmm. We have to acknowledge that, too.
Right.
We can't just necessarily label them as haters. We have to say, hey, you know, what I do is a reflection of who I am, and therefore, oh, okay, well, you're attracted to me or my personality because this is what I've done. So it's natural. We understand.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We understand.
Yeah. I mean, there's also motivation. A lot of times... people motivation to do things, they get involved, like say in the movie business or something, there's so many different motivations to do it, you know.
Certainly.
I mean, actors and actresses, you know, either, you know, you could, I want to be a really good actor, or I want to be a star, you know, there's different motivations for things, but your motivation to basically do what you can to help our South Florida artists and filmmakers in our whole area here raise the bar here.
Definitely.
And provide an outlet for those type of things. I think that's a great motivation. And those are the kind of, I believe, those are the kind of true motivations that have the most momentum.
Right.
No matter how much personal momentum you put into, like, I want to be a star and I'm really motivated to be a star, you're going to go so far. But if you, let's say if you're, I really want to, you know, I love acting or I love writing, that's really all I want to do. I think that is more of the slow, steady kind of burn that gets your rocket all the way to Mars, so to speak, you know, as opposed to like, I want to be a star, boom, and you go up to the upper atmosphere maybe, but, you know.
Get back with those aliens.
Did you get? Yeah. Yeah, I had to slow that.
Certainly.
I like to speak in metaphors sometimes. I don't know.
That's definitely a beautiful thing. And, you know, what you said just now is very, very, you know, it definitely hit home, you know, because the fact that, you know, when it comes to pursuing your dreams and something that you're passionate about, you know, it comes with, you know, the consideration of, you know, what is the end result?
Mm.
You know, who benefits from you pursuing your dreams? And, you know, you want to try to not be selfish with it.
Right.
You want to try to have your ambitions, you know, not too selfish and self-centered, but more or less related to the betterment of the human race.
Exactly. And it starts with your own backyard, so to speak. And that's what we're talking about here. Our own South Florida actor pool, writers, musicians, what we got down here. So.
Yeah.
You know, I'm with you 100% on that thing, and I'm happy to have you and AJ on my show here talking about your your film festival coming up here.
It's a pleasure to be here, Rick.
Yes,
sure, man.
You.
Absolutely.
Thank
I'm
you.
Looking forward to it. So give me a little bit of a personal history, you guys. You don't mind telling me a little bit about yourselves and how you got involved in film and what it is that motivated you. I want to hear from AJ, if you don't mind.
Well, I guess my story. I started in the entertainment business because of my best friend and very first client. She was out in LA pursuing acting, and I'm like, how can I be of assistance to you in helping you attain your goals? And I realized that I was looking at between becoming an agent or a manager. And I realized that with my personality type, I like to have close relationships with people. And so being a manager would be the best outlet to be able to help her do what she wanted to do. Mm-hmm. And in that, through that process, I realized that I can't be a manager of just one client. I had to expand what I do to others. And I dabbled in music for a little bit. And then I kind of crossed over into the film aspect because one of my first musical talents, he was doing a music video. And then there was a young lady on the set. I'm realizing that, okay, let me try to bring in other people as well. And I gravitated towards her. We've been rolling for a few years now, and we've had a great relationship. And I keep on growing and bringing on very talented people into my management company.
What's the name of your management company?
It Entertainment Group.
Okay. IIT. Okay.
Entertainment. Yeah, group.
And you consider? I mean, you are a management company.
Yes.
Talent management.
Talent management, and now we're moving into events with the WideScreen Film and Music Video Festival. So, you know, expanding, growing, and, you know, increasing the network and, you know, just making, I guess, more noise in this industry.
I guess we could use more of those, managing talent agencies down here. I mean, I guess out in Hollywood, there's like tons of them, you know. All the actors are looking to have an agent or you're not talking about being an agent, are you? Is that a different thing?
It's very different. Being a manager, agents are, I'm sorry to say, they're a little selfish. They only want you to work with them. And in South Florida, we're fortunate enough to, I guess the talent is fortunate enough to be able to work with many different agents. And so my job as a manager is to be an extension of my clients. Mm. And so what I try to do is I try to put them with different agents, keep those relationships going, and just kind of be the balance in it. And, you know, sometimes be that air that the talent will listen to when, you know, there's maybe a communication breakdown, or, you know, the talent just trusts you enough to know that if you're saying to do this, and that it'll be good for them, they'll actually do it. So.
Okay. Do you have a business background in school or just an interest?
Well, I have, administrative background.
Oh, okay,
and so
good.
That's what, I have a master's in public administration.
Oh, that's important.
And yes. So I utilize those skills and I bring it to the table and
To the Florida table too, right?
To the Florida Hampton table. Yeah. Yes, as a moderator, I do that as well too, just to help out the industry, to be a part of it and to watch it grow. So
that's good. Well, I think Rose used to do all that stuff before, right? Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
That woman is a busy lady, huh?
She is.
She's a powerhouse.
Yeah. Yes.
How about you, Jared? Tell me a little bit about your career. If you know, where are you from? How long you've been down here?
And sure.
What got you involved in this crazy business here?
Well, I was actually born and raised in the Bahamas. I'm Bahamian.
I thought I recognized a little bit of an accent.
Definitely. So yeah. That's where my roots are. I moved here to Miami in 2008. And basically, I started in 2011. That's when I really got heavy into the film business, you know, in my it was my senior year of college. And basically, I realized that film was my true passion.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided that, you know, from that point forward, I was going to just pursue that wholeheartedly.
As a writer, in what aspect?
As a writer, director, producer.
Okay,
you know,
good.
Get into making films and stuff like that and, you know, putting projects together. And, you know, I realized that, you know, you only live once and time is limited. You know, you can't waste your time. And, you know, I have this mentality that, you know, tomorrow I'm gone. That's the mentality of tomorrow I'm gone. In other words, it means that everything that I want to accomplish, I need to do today. I need to live each day as if it were my last. you know? And with that said, that inspires a lot of things that I do on a daily basis to help to push things forward because, you know, I live each day, at least I try my best to live each day as if it were my last.
That is a very refreshing attitude.
Certainly.
It really is because, you know, in the long run, the time that you have here is the most important thing.
It is.
It's the most important commodity that you have. And we just a lot of people just wasted. You know, I mean, I did. A lot of times I think, oh, well, I'll put it off tomorrow. But that's a good attitude. And it's a very necessary attitude to be successful, especially in the film business, I think, or any business, really. But definitely. I think it carries a lot of weight, too. You know, when you have that attitude, something about it just kind of is attractive to people. And
definitely. Yeah, for
sure. You know, they know you're serious about it. Your motivations are, you know, more or less pure.
Yeah.
You know, not selfish.
You definitely have to stay motivated. I know I definitely listen a lot to Les Brown and Eric Thomas. Those are two motivational speakers.
Oh, yeah?
And Steve Jobs, some of the things he said. You know,
I listen to Jared.
I'm listening to him now.
I myself as well, I do a bit of motivational speaking myself, you know, and I try to provide motivation for others, including AJ and, you know, some of my other people that I'm close with. Because we all need motivation.
Sure we do.
You know, in order to keep living. Because life is hard. Life is very hard. Mm. And, you know, just like Sylvester Stallone said, you know, it's, you know, nothing is going to hit you harder than life itself. You know, but you got to get up and keep moving forward. That's what he said in Rocky. Mm. So, basically, you know, in as far as, you know, going forward from there, you know, I started to, you know, get into producing the films. And then I realized that, you know, there's so many artists around town that need an opportunity to shine and need an outlet for their work. There's people doing great quality work down here, great quality work across the globe, but it's just like they don't have a chance to have it recognized and be awarded for it. Mm-hmm. So that was, you know, one of the main inspirational factors behind the festival, and this is what I'm focusing on wholeheartedly now.
So when you first got involved with it, you said writer, producer. Was there like a, like for, like trying to relate it to my own experience as a musician? I was a musician, right? I mean, I love songwriting and all that stuff, but looking at the film business, I went in to the point as a writer first because I learned a lot about the film business in the years that I've been involved in it, you know, since 2007 actually. I know that there's a, you know, directing, producing, there's all this kind of stuff, but writing to me was the point where I entered into it there. And it looks like you have the same motivation. It was the story that you needed to tell was the first motivating thing to get you into that?
Yeah. Basically, the first project I did was called What Lies Beyond, and basically it was just a story.
Did you need to tell with that one?
I mean, it was just like a fun little project. I mean, it wasn't like a deep story. I'm trying to change the world or nothing. This is a little fun horror story that I was inspired to do because of some other horror movies I've seen that I didn't like.
Right.
And, you know, I just put it together and, you know, it started off as a joke, quite frankly.
That's
right. People started to take it seriously.
Yeah. So. Oh, man, now I have to do this. So you did, right? And this movie that you did, What Lies Beyond, it's a short film, right?
No, that's a feature, actually.
Feature film.
Comedy horror, yeah.
No, wait, Jared. Who does a feature film for their first thing? I mean,
That's, I mean,
go big or
honestly,
go home.
Yeah,
I guess.
Go big or go home.
I firmly believe in the go big or go home. You know, that I believe in that. And that's why it inspired me. I said, hey, you know, my first project is going to be a feature because I want to make a difference and I want to set myself apart from everybody else.
You're an inspirational character. I'm glad to have you here. Now, that project was in what year did you complete that project?
2013.
Okay, that was just last year.
Yeah.
And I guess you had recently screened that, right?
April 2014, we screened it at AMC. We had a screening, actually. The first screening was at Old Cinema in Miami Shores.
Oh, yeah.
That happened October 27, 2013. Mm-hmm. And then the big one, the grand screening, was at AMC in Aventura in April this year.
All right. So maybe we could talk a little bit about that project. But first of all, you have a little trailer for us, right?
Certainly.
All right. Hey, George. Can we play the trailer to What Lies Beyond here?
What can I do for you? was wondering if it's not too late to sign up for the research trip this weekend?
I'm sure. I'm letting you know what happened to us kids last year on the research trip.
What are you trying to accomplish by the end of this weekend?
Be specific.
What exactly did happen?
My research has begun.
Here we are. Seniors. Ecology majors. About to graduate. I say, let's go out with a bang.
Oh, twist! Twist time! Okay, back to right. Oh, it's gonna happen! Holy guacamole!
Wow, that looks funny and scary at the same time.
Thank you, man.
And sexy. You got them all in there.
Yes, sir.
And a feature film to boot for your very first one. And I got to tell you, by the looks of that trailer, very professionally done.
Thank you so much.
For your first project, I think I'm starting to hate you now.
Keep it coming.
Yeah, I mean,
I'll, lying, eh?
I'll, yeah, exactly. My experience hasn't been quite that good, you know, but let's talk about that
sure.
That film that looks you wrote,
yeah.
Directed and produced that film.
Yes, sir.
And it looks like you got a huge cast, mm-hmm. Like a whole bunch of, are they all local actors?
Yeah, yeah, actually all local actors, you know, very talented individuals that I've had the pleasure of working with.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I mean, it's edited really well. Who works with you in editing there?
I actually edited.
You do that as well?
Yeah, I do some editing too.
Hit this guy.
Now for the coloring was done by Anderson Gill.
Ah, see, you couldn't do that.
No, I couldn't do that.
In time.
Right. But the editing, yeah, I edited that trailer too. The sound design was done, part of it by Tristan John and by Craig Stottle and... this other guy who put the finishing touches on the sound, whose name's not coming to mind at this time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's really well done.
Thank you.
Everything from the score, you know, building up, mm-hmm. The sound design's very important too. I don't know. That's one thing I noticed in a locally produced films, that the sound is like usually the worst, you know, it's like an afterthought, you know, all mm-hmm. The dialogue has like noise and you know, each room you go into has a different sound.
Different tone, yeah, yeah.
And I don't hear any of that, at least on your trailer there. It's, everything is all smooth. It's like Hollywood.
Yeah, yeah. We actually, I appreciate that. We actually did a lot of ADR. A lot of ADR, you know, like coming into a studio like this and speaking directly into the mic while the actors lip sync.
Sure.
And that is a tedious process.
It is.
Because on our location where we shot the film, up in North Miami at Grinnell's, the fact is the sound was very bad.
Well, you're outside for a lot. Yeah.
We had to do ADR. We had to overdub, you know, a lot of stuff. Yeah. A lot of work, man. It took us almost 2 years to complete.
Yep. Well, I believe myself that the difference between, you know, films that are really, excuse me, well done and just kind of thrown together is in these details.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. The more details you can you know, think of to apply, the more it starts to look like, you know, a professionally done film.
Yes, sir. Of course.
You know what? So if you have to have everybody do ADR, then but you know, that's even a tough thing. You know, I did that one of my first films, and you know, we did stuff that was outside, and my actor was like, he's yelling at something, right? That, so then we get him into a room, and okay, now do the same thing. It's like, hey,
yeah, it's hard to recreate it. Yeah,
yeah, it's hard
to call you out, man. You got to get it started.
Spotlight. There will be an ambulance standing by, though. I will actually bust my move.
No, definitely. We're looking forward to that. These are going to be highlights of the festival. We want people to get into the groove. It's a film and music video festival. So, sure. You know, picture yourself like when you go to Ultra or when you go to other festivals, you want to get into it. You know, it's not just meant for you to sit there and absorb. Mm-hmm. You want to get up and engage. You want to interact. You want to nudge the person next to you. Hey, wake up. Come on. You know, yeah. Let's get into it. The music video is about to come on. And artists will appreciate this because it's like, oh, man, people are jamming to my tunes.
Yeah.
And filmmakers will obviously appreciate the praise they get. And they will also have a chance to verbally at the end of their film or music video at the very end to speak and talk about their experience making the project. Yeah. And the audience gets to vote on, you know, which production is their favorite as well. We have audience awards, so that's going to be pretty fun.
Oh, is that how that's going to work out? I mean, is that a separate from your, you know, I know you have, you actually have some cash prizes for your thing, right?
The cash prizes are all audience awards. Audience votes for all the cash prizes, and then we have the judges awards that the judges decide.
Great. Yeah. That's great. Mm-hmm. So you got any corporate sponsorship for your event here, or how is that working?
SouthFloridaRadio.com is one of
them. SoFloRadio. SoFloRadio.com.
SoFlo. Yeah. Well, you know, that's the short version of it. But we're definitely working on that very actively, on that. So
you hear that, everybody out there?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We need sponsorships.
Yeah, we do.
This is a great film festival.
Great
here
exposure. Even billboard placement we got going on.
Oh, that's awesome.
Good exposure, yeah.
Thanks
to Joe Rubo, VIP TV.
Oh, yeah? Okay. Yeah. Thanks, Joe.
Yeah.
Thanks.
I noticed the one thing that you mentioned about when you have a live performance or a music video,
yeah,
that kind of atmosphere, it's different than when you see a film, you know? And when I was working, I like the transmedia things. You know, I've been doing a few of those things with our local Cinema Paradiso, where it's called Cine Musique, and we would bring live bands to perform in the theater, and at the same time have either their music video playing or some kind of imagery going on at the same time.
Okay.
So it's kind of like a combination of film, video, and live performance.
Sure.
Which is kind of... I've seen a few other Cinema Paradiso used to had an event that when I was first involved in the film business by a lovely person, Dawn Dubriel. She used to put on a great show, but it was they have live music outside, and we would play, and then they have artists. And then we would all have to go in and watch movies,
right?
Which is a different thing, because if you think about it, okay, everybody's drinking and listening to music, and yay, live music, yay, oh, this is great. We're all talking. Okay, everybody, let's go in here. Everybody sit down and everybody shut up now. Everybody watch this movie, because, you know, watching a movie, you know, it's not like, you know, you're talking and, you know, so it's a different thing, you know, combining those things.
And that's the main reason why we definitely want to. I know AJ is very passionate about the merging of film and music.
Good.
And
the main reason why we want to mix the music videos in between the films. Mm.
And also to inspire the filmmakers to use like local musicians when they're scoring too, to really create, like I said, that industry, that real entertainment industry where we're coming together.
Good.
So.
Well, we're on the same path with that. Absolutely. If anybody listened to our show tonight, this is what we're talking about here. We have a great bunch of musicians, a great industry of musicians and songwriters. And we have a bunch of really great actors and filmmakers.
Of course.
You know, we kind of should try to mix it up here together somehow.
Sure.
Make it more of a... So that they're not separate, you know, they could draw from the same well.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely.
I think that's a great idea. Yeah, I look forward to that. Now, you're mixing up your short films and your music videos together. What about, you're getting feature films?
Or oh, yes. Different? Yeah, features will be in there as well, too. Definitely. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, you got like, what is it, four or five days, right?
Yeah, we're running for 5 days, from the 27th to the 3rd, 5 days, yeah.
Right, and during that time, you said you got some workshops and things like that, right?
Yeah.
AJ, what kind of workshops do we have going here for festival?
Well, I know one of my plans for a workshop is to really do that merging, as we said, of the film and the music together. So I want to bring in industry professionals to come and speak to, you know, the talent. I want to bring in, you know, people who are on the film side, who are doing music, who are also doing music publishing companies, because those are the ones that help to facilitate the connection between getting artists' music into film, mm-hmm. and just, I guess, strengthen those bonds, and even to have a call for action, because even within our state, with our film incentives, there's also incentives for the music industry, but they can't actualize that, because right now, the way they have it is that if somebody makes a music video, they have to make it for $100,000. And then within a year, a fiscal year, spend $500,000 on music videos. I'm like, that's unrealistic. So it's just getting that knowledge out there and letting people know, and so that we can really, I guess, push that forward to really create that industry at the high level for us as well.
Well, if you have plan on having any local original bands that you'd like to feature or play there, I have a bunch of guys that I know of that that awesome. Have music videos, and love to be a part of something like that.
Certainly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So
fun.
Yeah, that's great. I'm really looking forward to this this event coming up here, Jared.
It's definitely.
Sounds like it's going to be a real big success. Were you surprised that you get up at 4 o'clock in the morning and decide on October 12th that I'm going to go ahead and do this, and here we are, and submissions coming in from all around the world, and everything's pretty much set up. Were you surprised that came together? I have a feeling you weren't.
I mean, no, it's so funny that you mentioned that, because you're right. You're right in saying that. And the main reason for that is that I'm a dreamer. I am very futuristic. I see things before they happen.
I hear that.
You know, I'm a visionary.
Yeah.
So I saw this happening.
You see it happening.
You know, now when it happens, it's very exciting, and it's something that I appreciate, and it's something that I'm grateful for, because the vision becomes a reality. But this is something that I live for. So I saw this happening, and now it's like, you know, we're living in that reality. That was just once a vision.
That's an important thing to remember out there, people. Mm-hmm. You have to see it done. It's just like a movie. Like if you want to do a movie, or you're going to write a movie, you have to see it in your head. You know, you have to, and you got to keep going for that, no matter day by day. Because you saw that thing in the end there, and you know you're going to get there. And that's the thing that'll carry you,
right?
Is that vision.
The vision.
Right? That inspiration to know that, hey, I can see this is what it's going to look like when it's done.
Yeah.
Right? Definitely. This is what it's going to look like when the widescreen film and music video festival is going on. You're going to have tons of people and great films, and everybody's going to love it. And you see that.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And that's why all the business and all the details
reflect
that it takes to get there
are
just something that has to be done, because, you know, you already see the end.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's a good way to look at it.
Yep.
Yeah, I see that. All right. Well, I'm really looking forward to seeing this thing come out here, and I'm glad to be a part of it. It's what are the dates again?
February 27th through March 3rd.
All right, February 27th.
So our submissions are now open, and submissions close on February 8th, 2015. Okay. And the festival is February 27th, 2015, until March 3rd.
So let me ask you this. Having not been involved with the inner workings of a film festival, I can only imagine the process by which films are decided upon and or viewed. Do you have like a panel?
Yes.
Are you prepared to you know, view 1,500 films or whatever you think you're going to get? How does that work?
Yes, we have a panel of very professional individuals throughout South Florida. And basically, it's, you know, it's a bit too many to name, and I don't want to leave anybody out. But I'm very, very professional. You know, think of all of the top-notch individuals around South Florida that are heavily involved in the film business.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we have them involved in the panel now. Basically, the only drawback with being, I wouldn't say drawback, but the only, I guess, the only thing about being on the panel is that you cannot submit your own projects. So say, sure. For example, Rick, if you were on the panel, you couldn't submit your project.
Well, that makes sense. Yeah.
So, you know, there were a few people who said, hey, I have projects I really want to submit. Therefore, I'll opt not to be on panel. But there were those that either didn't have projects or had projects, but they were like, hey, I'll maybe wait for later.
Mm-hmm.
And they are on the panel that we pride ourselves in, you know, viewing the projects, because it's a conflict of interest if I myself or the executive team chooses the films. That's political and that's a conflict of interest. And we want to sort of avoid the whole politics behind most festivals.
Mm-hmm.
We want to choose films based on merit and quality. So,
not by popular person or, yeah. or who's cool you want to impress. Have you guys viewed the films yet, or that you've gotten in, or how do you stay ahead of that? Or hope you don't have like a big movie night. Everybody, let's watch all these films now.
No. We're definitely on top of things. We have a very efficient system with our judges where we have them, you know, view the films on a regular basis so that, you know, the films don't pile up and, you know, we don't want any film, you know, no film left behind. We're not going to have any film get left behind in the trenches. Every film's going to be viewed and properly, objectively critiqued.
Right.
Based on a solid criteria in which we rate the films, you know, based on things like cinematography, directing, acting, performance, you know, sound, editing, music, you know, those are the various things that we look at. Nothing subjective, you know, nothing like, oh, you know, I didn't really like her hair, or, you know, I don't really like the way she talks. No, that's subjective. We're not fooling with that. We're focusing on the objective aspects that make or break a film so that, you know, in the event that, you know, perhaps a film lacks in certain areas, then we can provide detailed feedback to the filmmaker so that they can improve for next time.
Wow, that's an added bonus. Usually you just get a rejection letter. Hey.
No. We will be providing detailed feedback to our filmmakers, and we're looking forward to, you know, having them improve their craft. That's part of our mission. Yeah. Our mission is to inspire the creation and distribution of art while ultimately enhancing the creative mind. That's part of our vision.
That sounds like you're like a statement right there, like a vision. Yeah,
that's us. WideScreen Fest. That's us.
Man, looking forward. That's great. Mm-hmm. Well, it sounds like you got it all together, and I can't believe really October 12th to come up with this and to have all this stuff going.
Yeah,
and also to have, you know, all the number of people that are involved in it,
right?
And the quality of people that are involved in it. Says a lot to the person here, Jared Knowles, I think, that
people go,
yeah, I want to get behind this guy. I hear what he's saying, and I can tell his heart is he's sincere. And,
definitely.
You know, so that carries far. It's quite impressive.
Thank you, Rick.
You bet, man. I'm really looking forward again. I keep saying that. But
No, that's good. That means it's on your mind. So yeah, that's great.
It is.
And that's what we want. That inspires us to keep working.
Yes.
You know, it's rough. You know, we meet on a regular basis. And, you know, it's rough. It's not easy.
No,
you know, the team is all, you know, definitely working their butts off.
Details.
You know, keeping things moving. So, you know, things like that inspire us.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because really none of us are on a salary or anything. So it just inspires us to just keep moving forward.
Right.
And that's the goal.
So December 1st was the opening date for submission. And as you say, it is now December 4th.
Yeah.
And you had at least 25 or so submissions.
Yes.
That's before you got here.
Definitely.
So let's extrapolate here. And how many films do you think you'll have submitted here? How many projects you'll think you have submitted?
By the deadline?
Yeah, by the deadline.
Well, that's something that, you know,
you
I haven't
think
really...
about that at all, or...
Yeah, I mean, well, to be honest with you, yeah, I have put a lot of thought into it as far as a goal that I have in mind that I want to market and efforts to work toward, but that's something that I couldn't disclose.
Mm. Okay.
Yeah. Is this a secret?
It's a secret. All right. Sorry, it's radio show. Yeah.
No, no, no problem. I'll tell you after.
Ask off the air. I'll whisper in your ear after.
All right. It sounds cool.
Yeah.
All right, Jared Knowles. Thank you very much. I appreciate you coming on my show.
Oh, it was a pleasure.
Radio. Thank
it was
you
a pleasure.
Very much.
And, so flow.
Yeah, man.
Definitely.
It's going to be great. AJ, my dear.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you for having us.
SoFlo Radio for the win. It was awesome.
Yes, yes, yes. And we're going to have Jared back here when we get a little closer to the widescreen film and music video festival.
Amen, amen.
We'll have you back here, and we'll be all excited about listening and getting ready for the show to come up.
Perfect.
All right, everybody. Thanks. Thanks for joining me on Rick's show on the radio on SoFloRadio.com. And wait, sorry, George. I gave you the cue wrong here. I want to make a little announcement about next week's show. We are going to be having my friends. We're going to do like a Christmas South Florida style with a really great surf band coming in, cut back, playing some surf music, which is very Christmassy, don't you think?
Amen.
Yeah.
So we're looking.
I'll wear my Christmas hat.
Yeah,
Christmas
good.
In South Florida.
Yeah, yeah. So we'll wear our surf, our bring your boards and your swimming trunks and your Christmas hats.
And bikinis.
And bikinis, right.
Oh, yeah.
Little polka dot bikinis.
Yeah.
Very little.
All right, that's next week on Rick's Show on the Radio. And thanks again, you guys. And we'll see you next week on SoFloRadio.com.
Perfect.
This is the South Florida Radio Network.